The year is 2018. The Marvel Cinematic Universe has been building for 10 years, and it has become bigger than anyone could have imagined. Every single movie in the MCU has led up to the third Avengers movie, Infinity War. It was well known at this point that Thanos was set to be the villain of this movie, as he's made multiple cameos throughout some of the movies leading up to Infinity War. But nothing could have prepared us for the Thanos that we got on screen. From his incredible opening monologue to the final shot of his relieved, victorious face, every second is gold. So how did they do it? Creating a villain for a cinematic universe a decade in the making is a near impossible task, and yet they surpassed expectations. In this video, we're going to take a closer look at Thanos and figure out why he is the perfect villain. My whole life, I've always been a big superhero fan. The most important superhero movies to me growing up were the Sam Raimi Spider-Man trilogy, the two Fantastic Four movies, and all of the X-Men movies. Seeing all of my favorite heroes in movies was always my favorite medium to see them in. I liked the TV shows and comic books as well, but there was always something magical about seeing Spider-Man swing around New York City in real life. Growing up on these movies, I was thrilled to see Iron Man when it came out in 2008. And year after year, movie after movie, I stuck with the MCU for the next 10 years. Infinity War had a decade's worth of buildup as well as over 40 characters to balance, and by some miracle, they absolutely nailed it. I was blown away by Infinity War after seeing it for the first time, and I went back to see it in the theaters 4 more times after that. This masterpiece of a movie owes a good portion of its success to its main villain, Thanos. He's made from the perfect ingredients. He has an intimidating appearance, good evil intentions, the bite to match the bark, and the secret ingredient, godlike dialogue. This section is perfectly summed up by Doctor Strange when he first meets Thanos on Titan, and he says,
"Oh yeah. You're much more of a Thanos."
Strange says this, having previously encountered Ebony Maw and Cole Obsidian, who don't quite look the part of Thanos, given his reputation. As soon as he sees the real Thanos, though, he knows that there's no mistaking him. His size helps a great deal, but it isn't the only factor that makes his appearance intimidating. As a matter of fact, Cole Obsidian is actually a fair bit larger than Thanos, and even still, just by looking at the two, you can tell which one fits Thanos' reputation. I believe that it's his face that sets him apart. Thanos is a CGI marvel, and I think what impresses me the most is how accurate his face looks. He genuinely looks real, and you can see Josh Brolin's menacing glares through Thanos' eyes. And it does wonders for his intimidation factor. For another example, look at Walter White from Breaking Bad. He isn't intimidating in the slightest, and this is poked fun at throughout the series, but when he puts on his mean face, he looks like a totally different character. This is how Thanos looks almost all the time. Mix this with a body that's over 8 feet tall and almost 1,000 pounds of pure muscle, you've got yourself one intimidating boy. Thanos' goal in Infinity War is to wipe out half of the population in the universe, to make the universe a paradise for the remaining half. Obviously, destroying life on a scale hitherto undreamt of—
Did you seriously just say hitherto undreamt of?
—is extremely evil. So what's with the oxymoron? What do I mean by good evil intentions? Well, it's all about the presentation. If Thanos were your run-of-the-mill, mustache-twirling villain that just wanted to wipe out half of the universe, he wouldn't be compelling. What makes his intentions good is his genuine belief that what he is doing is right. Whenever he explains his plans to Gamora, Doctor Strange, or anyone else, you can see that he fully believes that he is doing this to save the universe from destroying itself. He sums it up best himself in this line.
"It needs correction."
"You don't know that!"
"I'm the only one who knows that. At least I'm the only one with the will to act on it."
In the comics, Thanos' goal of wiping out half of the universe is the same. But his reason for doing it is different. He's trying to impress the personification of death because he's in love with her. To do so, he decides to collect the Infinity Stones and commit genocide on a scale hitherto undreamt of. It's a lot easier to just hate comic Thanos because he's just trying to kill a lot of people for his own self-gain. But MCU Thanos believes he is the tragic hero of the universe, tasked with committing an act that no other being has the strength to do. He is so dedicated to his goal that he even sacrifices the only thing that he truly loves in the universe, his daughter, in order to achieve it. You can see the amount of genuine pain and regret that he feels having to do this. And even though this monster just murdered his own daughter, you can't help but feel a little bit of pity for him. That is a good villain. Throughout the movie, you constantly have to ask yourself just how evil is Thanos really? When a villain's intentions are as blatantly evil as Thanos's are, and you still question just how evil they truly are, those are good evil intentions. So, he's got the look and the reputation, but can he back what he talks about with his actions? Well, that question gets answered in the first 10 minutes when Thanos puts a clinic on the Hulk.
And of all the superlatives...
who we've been led to believe was the strongest Avenger. He also does this without using the Infinity Stones, so right off the bat, we know that he means business. And it doesn't stop there. At every turn, Thanos repeatedly proves that he is a force to be reckoned with. From easily dismantling the Guardians of the Galaxy, going toe-to-toe with the Sorcerer Supreme, and throwing a literal moon out of orbit at Iron Man. By the time he teleports to Wakanda to get the final stone, the audience fully knows that nobody stands a chance at stopping him. He easily wipes out some pretty powerful Avengers and is only slightly confused that Captain America was even able to just stop his hand for a moment. When he finally has all of the stones, and he actually follows through with his plan with just the snap of his fingers, half of the life of the universe is gone, and by that point in the movie, it's fully believable that Thanos would have the power to do it. I've saved this part for last because I think it's the most important. Prior to Infinity War, we had only heard Thanos speak a few lines which had hyped him up to be the big scary villain that he is.
Fine. I'll do it myself.
But it's his first lines in Infinity War that drive home who Thanos really is.
Dread it. Run from it. Destiny arrives all the same.
And now it's here. Or should I say, I am.
This is how you introduce a villain of Thanos' caliber. Every line after this is also just amazing. There's a reason that almost all of Thanos' lines are so quotable. And it's because every word that comes out of his mouth is iconic.
You should choose your words more carefully. No resurrections this time. Perfectly balanced, as all things should be. I'm the only one who knows that. At least I'm the only one with the will to act on it. I'm sorry, little one. This day extracts a heavy toll. With all six stones, I could simply snap my fingers. They would all cease to exist. I call that mercy. The hardest choices require the strongest wills.
Insect.
You should have killed me.
It would have been a waste of part.
All that for a drop of blood.
Now, there's no time at all.
You should have gone for the head.
What did it cost?
Everything.
Now, of course, none of these lines would carry the weight that they do if it weren't for Josh Brolin's deep, commanding voice delivering them. He really was the perfect cast for this role. I can't think of anyone else that could deliver these lines as well as he did. The point is, when Thanos speaks, you listen. And that is one of the most important qualities in a good villain. Thanos is a once-in-a-lifetime movie villain, and I appreciate everybody involved in his creation for bringing him to life. From the writers, the CG artists, the Russo brothers, and Josh Brolin himself. In this analysis, you probably noticed that I only talked about Thanos in Infinity War. And I did this because I think Thanos is perfect in Infinity War, but not so much in Endgame. He's still great, don't get me wrong, but he's different. The Russos even differentiated them as Warrior Thanos and Philosopher Thanos. And even though Warrior Thanos is supposed to be more evil and scary, I find Philosopher Thanos far more menacing and compelling. The MCU has had its fair share of villains, but none have lived up to Thanos, and sadly, I don't think any ever will. I would love to be proven wrong, but I have not been a fan of any of the recent MCU projects, and my faith in the MCU is at an all-time low.
Bruh!
The recipe that led to Thanos' perfection is not the recipe for any perfect villain. There are many different kinds of villains that work in all different kinds of movies, but as far as superhero movies go, Thanos is as perfect as it gets. Thank you for watching. I appreciate you taking the time out of your day to watch me gush about a big purple alien. If you want to see more content like this, please consider subscribing. I hope to upload more consistently in the near future, and I've got plenty of ideas ready to go. So, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.